This bard's tale begins near White Orchard, with my dear friend Geralt of Rivia seeking his lover of yore, the sorceress Yennefer. She'd eluded him for years, but now seemed just a few steps ahead.
Black, saturated with blood. Nilfgaardians were celebrating. Griffin interrupted them. A camp. Are older and deeper, heavily armored. Nilfgaardians, probably. Griffin's nest. What remains of it, at least. Corpse is a couple of weeks old. Still alive when the Griffin brought him here. Took a long time dying. Female. Larvae in her wounds have already hatched. Been dead at least a week. Either Griffin must be a male. Deep cuts over the whole body. Not a drop of blood on the beak or claws. Didn't defend herself. Crept up on her while she slept. Beak tips worn. Gray hairs in the coat. 10, 12 years old. Griffins pair off for life when young. Male must be about the same age. Thick shaft. Dense barbs. A royal griffin. Explains why the male I ran into was so aggressive. Hunted the Nilfgaardians down here in the forest first, then started prowling the area. Done all I could. Should talk to Vesemir.
Giddy up.
The infamous well. Strange, no sign of a ghost. Maybe it only shows at a certain time of day.
Whoa! Come on.
Body. I'd reach it from here. Lucky not to come up empty-handed. A bracelet with an inscription. To Claire, from Volker. Bracelet must have belonged to the woman in the well.
faster.
Around the well scorched. A corpse hanged by the bucket rope. Wide pelvis, small jaw. A woman. Around 30, judging by the teeth. Left arm's missing. Wide pelvis, small jaw. A woman. Journal might be useful. Wide pelvis, small jaw. A woman. Around 30, judging by the teeth. Left arm's missing. Was she wearing the bracelet from her husband? Might be why her arm fell off.
Run, Roach. Slow now. Let's go! Not so fast, Roach. Slow now.
Wide pelvis, small jaw. Was she wearing...